Hi everyone, today we will discuss about adder and subtractor in binary numbers. Digital computer performs various arithmetic operations. The most basic operation, no doubt, it is the addition of two binary digits. This is simple addition consists of four possible elements operation. Suppose we will take one example. The number is 010 added with 111. So, if you take as a weighted form the 010, we know that 010 weightage is 2 in a decimal and 111 weightage is 7 in decimal. If you add 7 plus 2, we know that we will get 9 as a decimal number. If you convert it back into the binary, we have to get as a 101. So, how to do it directly in the binary number? Let's check. So, first we'll take 010 as a first number and second number as 110. Suppose we add with 0 and 1s, so we know that answer is 1 because adding with anything is 0, the result is 1. Next, if you add 11, usually in the decimal if you add 112, like that we'll get, but binary, the maximum number possible is 1, so you cannot make as a 2 number. So, we have to make it as a 1 to the carry part and 0 as a addition. Suppose in decimal, if you take as a addition of 9 plus 1, we are taking as a 0 here and carry is 1. The similar way, because in decimal 10 is a base, so we cannot write 10 number. Similar way in the binary, if it is more than 1 we will get, we will check that 1 to the carry part and making 0 into the result part. So, it will make as a 0 here and carry to the next. In this part, we are taking 1 here and 0, 1. So, again it become 1, 1. Again we will get as a 0 and carry is 1. The carry is last bit. So, finally we are getting 1, 0, 0, 1 is our final answer. What we discussed, the decimal as a 9. In adder, usually we have two types, half adder and full adder. What is this half adder means? If you are adding two binary numbers, it is called as a half adder. If you are adding three binary numbers, usually it is called as a full adder. Now, we can go with the truth table and other operations like logic equation, K-map and logic symbol and logic diagram, how it look like for half adder, step by step we can discuss. First, we will go with the truth table. Suppose if it is the number is 00, if you add this 0 plus 0, usually we know that any addition of 0 is result to the sum also 0 and carry also 0. Next combination, if you take 0 plus 1, usually what happens, the 1 is present here, so you will get sum and there is no carry. Next, if you go with 10, again it is an addition of simple 10s, so sum is 1, carry is 0. And the final one, the possibility is 1 plus 1. If you make 1 plus 1, already we discussed, it is making as a sum is 0 and creating the carry or generating the carry. From this we can draw the K-map, so we can form the equation from this truth table. So, already we know that K-map how to do it for the two variable input. We are taken as a A bar A in the row side and the first part is we are calling as a 0, then 1, 2, 3 like that. We have to take two K-map here, one for the sum portion and one for the carry portion. So, we will begin with the K-map. Here, sum portion, it's actually consists on A bar position and B1 position. So, A bar and B1 position is this one. So, sum is present here. And once again, the sum is present in A and B bar position. So, nothing but in this condition, A and B bar. So, other condition, it is 0 and 0. So, usually for this, we cannot make any grouping possibility here. So, we will make this one as a one group and this one as a one group. Usually, we are getting as a The first group, this one, as it is the formula A bar B, and this one is A B bar. So if you add these together, you will get logic equation of sum. So sum is equal to, you will get as A bar B plus A B bar. And already we know that what is A bar B and A B bar look like. It is nothing but a XOR gate. So we can call as a XOR. Similar way, we can move on to the carry. So carry is 1 present only the last condition 1 plus 1. That is nothing but AB. So if you go with here, the AB condition is this position. So 1, all the condition is 0. So usually these conditions came up just for your verification. You can take directly also possible. So in this condition, it is AB. So we have the carry equation is something called as a AB. Already we know that from the basic gate, AB is nothing but it is a AND gate of B. That also we can take. So this is all about the logic equation, K-map and truth table of the half adder. So we will go with the what is the logic symbol of the half adder. So any combination circuit, already we are discussed, it contains some input and output. So we are drawing the process of half adder. It contains two input. We are calling that two input is A and B. So it has two output. One is we are calling as a sum RS and another one is carry. So we have two input and two output, and the middle process is half adder. This is the logic symbol of the half adder. Now how to do the logic diagram? Previous equation we can take here to make the logic diagram. So we know that sum is equal to we got as a XOR B and carry we got as a AND B. So we will go with this equation. First take as a as a one input and B is another one input. So from this AB, first draw the XOR gate. Whatever answer you will get, that is the sum. Similar way, you can take A and B to the AND gate portion, and whatever you will take is carry portion. This is how the logic diagram we can draw the half adder. Next we will discuss on the full adder. The full adder is nothing but it is a three binary numbers. If you are adding three binary numbers, it known as a full adder. So first we can discuss about the truth table, how full adder can be drawn. If all are zero, we know that sum we can take as a zero. And similar way, first we will discuss only sum, later we will go about the carry portions. Here in ABC, there is a only one present. To do easily the three binary numbers addition, instead of doing the common classic method, you can check that how many number of one present in this. If number of one present is one, then sum is one. If number of one present is two, then sum is zero, carry is one. And then if number of one present is 3, then both sum and carry is 1. This method you can use it. So you can take the simple method, that is number of 1 of binaries is 1. Okay, number of 1 is 1. Then we can usually call as a sum is 1 and carry is 0. If number of 1 is 2. So what happens? The sum is 0 and carry is 1. If number of 1 is 3, then sum is also 1, carry is also 1. This method is easy to make you make as a sum and carry answers. So in this condition, only 1 present in ABC, so sum is 1. And in this, 2 1s are present to make sum 0. In this, only 1 present, so make sum 1. In this, the two ones are present, so make sum 0. Again here, two ones are present, make sum 0. And here, three ones are present. From this last condition, if three ones, then sum is 1. So go with sum is 1. Similar way, go for carries. What is the carry condition? If number of 1 is only 1, then carry is 0. So here, there is no 1, so carry is 0. Then number of 1 is 1 here, so make it carry 0. And here third condition, also number of 1 is only 1, so make it carry 0. In this condition, usually number of 1 is 2, so carry is 1. from this second condition. If number of 1 is 2, then sum is 0, carry is 1. So again, if you go with the condition 100, the only one present in this, so carry is 0. Again, if you go with 101, two number of 1s, so it is carry 1. Again, 110, it is two number of 1s, carry 1. And the last condition, three number of 1s, so again it is carry 1. Like this, you can do the sum and carry table. From this, you can go for the K-map. So here, wherever sum is present, check it out. Sum is present in the this condition. This is nothing but one condition. And this is nothing but two condition. This is nothing but four condition. This is nothing but seven condition. So 1, 2, 4, 7 sum is present. So make it 1, 2, 4, 7 as a sum high. So this K-map, take it for sum. And the present is 1 and 2 and 4 and 7. So these portions, the sum is present. And here there is no grouping possible. You can do only individual grouping possible. So make it as an individual grouping and write the equation. So from this logic equation is look like this: A bar B bar C plus A bar B C bar plus A B bar C bar plus A B C. And if you look like a truth table of this sum, it is if only one odd number of 1 present, it is getting high. So it is look like your XOR gate operation. So you can take directly the XOR operation here. So you can make it as a XOR B XOR C. So this is the equation for the your sum. So we can take sum is equal to, the equation is A XOR B XOR C. Now we can move to the carry portion. So in the carry, wherever it is high, the high it is in the third condition. This is 3 and this is 5, this is 6 and this is 7. So we can go for 3, 5, 6, 7. So in this we can make it how grouping possible in K-map. So usually we can do 5, 7, 1 grouping possible, and you can do one more grouping is 7 and 6 possible. One more grouping is 3, 7 possible. So the first grouping 5 and 7, the B bar B get cancelled. So it is in the A row. So it is AC. Plus the second grouping 7 and 6, you can take something like that. B is common and it is AP. And the last condition 3 and 7, it is the two row get cancelled. So it is BC. So we can call that the carry equation is nothing but, we can call like AC plus AB plus BC. Similar way, we got the equation of the full adder. Now we can move on the logic symbol for full adder. Any combination of circuit, first draw the one blocks here, and whatever name of that particular circuit, write it here. So we are writing as a full adder in this block. And now check it out, how many input for full adder and how many output. In full adder, it is nothing but 3 input and 2 output. So make it like this, the 3 input namely A, B and C. And output or any adder is always 2, one is sum, another one is carry. The difference between half adder and full adder only 2 input, full adder we have 3 input. From the logic equation, we know that sum is equal to, we are taken as a XOR B XOR C, and the carry is nothing but AB plus BC plus CA. From this we can draw the logic diagram. Now try for logic diagram of the full adder. So we have 3 input. First take A, B and C. So we are taking all 3 together to the sum portion. So take all the 3 and make it as a XOR gate, and make it as a something like S is equal to A XOR B XOR C. For carry portion, we required A and B C. So take from, one is from A, another one is B, that is A B. Make it as a AND gate and take it. Second one is BC, so it is look like a sum of product, so take second one is BC, and last one is CA, so take from one is A and another one is from C, so you can do as a AC. So from this we have three AND gate, from these two you can make it as a OR gate. So the final answer is nothing but AB plus BC plus CA. This is nothing but the carry out. In the XOR gate, when you are writing, write like this. This is how we can draw the full adder logic circuit. Now we can move on the subtraction part. In binary subtraction, how we can do? Suppose the one example, if you take the subtract the binary number 101 from 1011, how we can do it? Usually, if it is any subtraction from 1 minus 1, we know that usually it is 0. When 1 minus 0, it is also similar the previous, that is nothing but 1. When question arises, when it is 0 minus 1. So, we cannot do 0 minus 1. So, we have to take borrow from the next bit of the our left side, and from that we have to take, and don't take as a 1 it is, you have to take that one as a 10. So 10 minus 1 we usually call as a, if you take as a 10 it is the weightage of 2, and if it is minus with the 1, so usually 10 minus 1 we are getting as a 1 only. So your answer is 1, and because of taking borrow 1, your left bit becomes 0, so your answer becomes 0 here. So if you take in a decimal, the 1011 is nothing but 11, and 101 is 5. If you make 11 minus 5, you have to get 6. So 0110 is nothing but 6. In half subtractor, we are using two binary number as subtracted. As we are done in half adder, the half meaning is only two numbers we are using. So in half subtractor, two numbers we are taking as a two variable like A and B, and two output like difference and borrow. So borrow we are calling as a B naught, because of the input side also the B variable there, so output side we can call as a B naught. We know that if A and B both are 0, so when you do difference, the difference becomes 0 and borrow also 0. When you go with 0 1, the actual issue in this one, very very important part in the half subtractor, when 0 1, the 1 is actually there in this side, so 0 minus 1 not possible, so you have to take one extra, that is borrow become high. And when you make 10 in this, 10 minus 1 is 1, so difference also 1, borrow also 1. When you made 10, so obviously the difference is 1, but borrow become 0 only. So when you make 1 1, so difference also 0 and borrow also 0. So when you take this type of truth table, after go for the K map. In the K map, we usually know that wherever the 1 present, that portion we can add it. So in this condition, first you can take for difference portion. So D, it is present in 0 1 and 10 condition. So 0 1 is nothing but A bar B, and 10 nothing but A B bar. It is as usual what we are done in half adder sum portion. So when you do this equation, it is nothing but A bar B first, then A B bar. Already we know that A bar B A B bar is nothing but A XOR B. So when you taken as a equation portion, so logic equation become for the difference is, it is nothing but A XOR B, and it is exactly equal to in half adder whatever we are taken for sum portion. So sum and difference are usually same equation. Now we can move on the borrow portions. In borrow, it is only the condition of 0 and 1. So the 0 and 1 means A bar B condition. So it is 1 here, we can directly take, it is nothing but A bar B. So the borrow equation is B naught is A bar B. First we can do with the logic symbol. Already we discussed in logic symbol, any combinational circuit, draw the block and write the whichever particular process you are doing. So we are doing half subtractor. Half meaning always two input. So make it A and B as an input. And output is two things. One is it is difference. Another one is bar of B naught. So before going to the logic diagram, first we can check what is the equation. Difference, we know that it is A XOR B, and bar O, we check that it is A bar B. So in the logic diagram, first take A and B portion. So A B as it is for the XOR position. So it is nothing but the whatever we got in half subtractor sum. So difference is equal to A XOR B. Now we had to make as a bar O. So A become A bar. So make it as a NOT gate to the A, and B directly take and make it AND gate, and this is called bar O, A bar B. This is how the half subtractor structure come to the picture. Now we can move on the full subtractor. The name itself says full means it is 3 bit. So how to make this full subtractor truth table? Usually the previous full adder, I told some technique how to do it. Similar way we can do here one technique. The technique is you have to make one virtual difference what column I make here. This is actually not required in any truth table anywhere, but we can make it this one as a virtually, that we can easily make out what is difference and borrow here. Suppose the first condition it is 0 0. Now we know that the virtual difference, that means if it is only half subtractor portion we will take first here. So 0 0 is actually the difference is 0, and if borrow 0, don't fill it, simply leave it like that. Again the 0 0 condition it is 0. 0 1 condition we know that in the 2 bit difference is 1 and borrow also 1. Similar way here 0 1, so difference is 1, borrow is 1. Similar way when you go with 1 0, we know that the 1 0 difference is 1 and borrow is nothing, so don't fill anything in the borrow side. Again 1 0 it is 1. In 1 1 we know that 1 1 become as a 0 in the difference, so go with the 0 here and 1 1 here also 0. This is actually whatever I had done, it is actually the half subtractor difference to make it easy for us to make whatever. Now whatever answer we got, we have to go with the C1 and difference borrow you have to fill. 0 0 means difference and nothing come to the picture, so borrow will become 0. And in this case 0 1, so we know that 0 1 borrow is 1, so difference also 1. In this case the 1 0, so 1 0 usually the difference is 1, but borrow already we are written, and 1 1 the difference is 0. Now come to the next part. 1 0 the difference is 1 and borrow previously not written, here also it is not generated, so it is 0. And this condition 1 1, the difference actually 0 1 1 and borrow also 0. And 0 0 condition difference also 0, borrow also 0. And last condition 0 1, we know that if it is 0 1 comes, difference 1 and borrow 1. So from these condition we can do it. If you want to know more about, check it out. If it is 0 and 0, then usually we will get as a, already we know that if it is 0 0 or 1 1, we usually get as a difference is 0, borrow also 0. If it is 1 0, the difference is 1 but borrow is 0. If it is 0 1, both are high. These are the condition for the half subtractor. Similar method we used in this condition. For the K map, when you are going, for first we can check with the difference. So wherever difference high, check it out. This portion we usually called as a, it is 1 and this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So your convenience. So it is high for 1, 2, 4 and 7. It is same as a the previous full adder sum portion. So make it like that. So it is present in 1, 2 and 4, 7. So all these are not groupable, and already we discussed about full adder sum. It is similar. So I will directly go to the our equation. It is the XOR gate. So A XOR, B XOR, C. Always one thing remember, in the full adder or full subtractor, the sum always equal to the difference equation, and both the side it is AXR BXR C. If it is half or full, it doesn't matter. In the subtractor and adder, the sum and difference remains same equations. So now we can go with the very important part, borrow B naught we can take. So wherever it present in 1, 2, 3 and 7. So go to 1, 2, 3 and 7. Now we can make as a grouping. The 1, 3 grouping is possible, and 2, 3 grouping is possible, and 7, 1 grouping is possible. Now 1, 3 grouping, how it is actually equation? The A bar is the row side, take it as it is, and the B bar B get cancelled, so it is A bar C. Plus, you can go with the 3 and 2, the A bar is a common thing here, and B is become common here because C and C bar get cancelled. If you go with the 3 and 7, so A bar A get cancelled and it look like a B C. So your equation become A bar C plus A bar B plus B C. To remember equation in subtractor, always remember like that. In the difference or in the carry and borrow, the A portion only it become A bar. Either it is half or full, it doesn't matter. In the addition or adder part, it is A only. If it is subtractor, instead of A you have to take A bar. In the carry, or it is in, we are calling as a B naught. So our final equation for borrow, it is A bar C plus A bar B plus BC. If you remember the carry equation, it is AC AB plus BC. So here only we are taking A bar instead of. So we can move on the next, the logic symbol. So first we can write the logic equation. So logic equation, we know that the difference is nothing but A XR B XR C exactly equal to the sum of the adders. And the borrow naught is equal to the carry, but only instead of A we have to take A bar. So A bar B and then B C and then A bar C. So these are the equation of the full subtractor. Logic symbol, you can draw something like that. First make it as a full subtract. So it has three input. We can take as a B and C as a three input, and output is, one is difference, so D. Another output borrow we can call as a B now. So logic diagram we can take like A, B, C we can take, and first we can do as a XR gate as we are done in the adder portion. So it is nothing but difference. It is A, XR, B, XR, C. And then we can move on the borrow portion. Only remember that wherever A, we have to take as a bar. So first try to do A bar and B. So it is A bar B. Then go for A bar C. So I have taken from A bar here and C. So it is A bar C. Then we can take B and C. So this portion actually B and the C as it is here. So we can make AND gate here and we can cut BC here. So all we have to make it as a R gate. So final answer of the borrow, B naught is equal to A bar B plus A bar C plus BC. This is how the full subtractor is designed. Next we move on the parallel adding. So what is this parallel adding means? Instead of doing the 2 bit or 3 bit, the similar 2, 3 bit together, whatever we are doing, that is called as a parallel adder. Suppose we will take one example. If you are taking as a 0, 1 and we add with the 1, 1 suppose. So here this portion, the first LSB bit, usually we can call as a half adder because we are not taking any carry over here. So whatever answer we will get directly. But when you are adding this 0, 1 to the next bit, you are taking any carry generated here to the this terminal. So this has three input. So usually this one called as a full adder. Similar way, one more number we have. The whatever answer we get from this, that carry also we are adding here, so again it become 3 adding. So this is the way how we can do the parallel adding. You can take one example, something like a0 a1 a2 and b0 b1 b2. So this a0 b0 doesn't carrying any carry, so we can take directly to the here, and this we can treat as a half adder. And half adder generated two things, one is sum and another one is carry. So whatever carry generated, that we are giving to the a1 b1. So this portion is the carry whatever generated given to this one, so another a1 b1 from the input side, similar way to the next a2 b2. So totally, for if you are making as a 3 parallel adding, so we will get due to the extra carry, so it is 4 bit. Already what we have discussed, the first place it is uses as a half adder, then second position and fourth position and eighth position we have to place as a full adders, and some appear in the output side here how it look like. Then we have to enter the binary numbers, whatever addition to here, and carry automatically it generated. So suppose if you take one number, something called 011 and 100, what happens here, the 0 numbers come here and B we are getting as a 1. So the addition of 01 we usually get as a 1, so this 1 comes this side, so we got as the answer 1. And from 01 there is no carry generated, so 0 comes into the this picture. And next number we are taking 0 here, so 0 is coming this side, and B is actually we are getting from the second number is 1, so this is 1 here. Again the 01, so addition we are getting 1, so this number become 1, and then the carry again it is 0. So the third number is 0 in the A side, and here again 0 in the B side. So when you make 0 0, the sum is 0 here, so we usually get 0, and carry also 0 here. So last number it is 0 and 1 here, so if you take as a 0 1, A is 1 and B is 0, so obviously the addition we are getting 1, and carry is nothing formatted, so 0. So final answer we are getting 0 1 0 1. This is how parallel adder works.